Today in Texas, the National Rifle Association's annual convention gets underway as the country engages in a heated gun control debate. NBC's Gabe Gutierrez is in Houston with this story. Gabe, good morning.
Savannah, good morning. More than 70,000 people are expected to attend this convention, which runs through Sunday. The slogan here, stand and fight. The NRA is riding high after a major congressional victory. Today in Houston, a 9-acre gun show in the middle of a national gun fight. About 550 exhibitors will kickstart the NRA's annual meeting. This afternoon, scheduled speakers include Sarah Palin, Rick Santorum, Bobby Jindal, and Rick Perry.
NRA members vote, and their friends vote, and that's what is driving all this.
After mass shootings in Aurora and Newtown, the NRA's opponents seem to have momentum.
This was a pretty shameful day for Washington.
But 2 weeks ago, a bipartisan compromise on expanded background checks for commercial gun sales was shot down in the Senate.
We don't mistake battles for wars. It was a victory in a battle, but the war continues.
I believe in the Second Amendment, and I'll fight to protect it.
Now, several gun control advocates are launching a coordinated effort ahead of the 2014 midterm elections. The groups claim they finally have the financial clout to challenge the NRA. Thanks to super PACs, backed by New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg and former Arizona Congresswoman Gabby Giffords.
We're simply losing too many loved ones to this epidemic, and it's time for change.
But here in this convention hall, people like Bill Dermody see it differently. He works for one of the nation's largest rifle manufacturers that employs 600 people.
My concern as an NRA member is that any legislation needs to be targeted towards criminals and not law-abiding people.
Outside the convention, gun control advocates are planning a vigil for the victims of gun violence, Matt.
Gabe Gutierrez in Houston this morning. Gabe, thank you very much.